Hello and welcome to the last unit of week 3. Today, I will continue to talk about SQL tuning tip. Today's SQL tuning tip is query inlining. SQL Script Optimizer has a logic to combine two or more of statements as possible, and this process is called inlining. Here is a simple example of procedure that contains inline feature. Inlining is used in order to simplify complex queries. If the queries are fully inlined, then many intermediate sequences are merged into one big step. Therefore, it is considered as beneficial for most procedures. However, a fully inlined queries can make the search space larger, so there can be a rare case inlining may lead to suboptimal plans. Let's have a look at the example of query inlining. Here, we call the main procedure called proc outer. Let's look at the definition of proc outer procedure. Within proc outer, there is a variable defined as tv1, and another procedure, proc inner, is called. And when you check out how proc inner is called, the defined table variable tv1 is entered as an input. And proc inner returns tv2, and tv2 has the result of select query from another input table variable called vtab. After proc inner is processed, there is another statement, select all from table variable tv2. And the table variable tv2 is actually from the result of proc inner procedure. After that, proc outer defines two variables, which is t1 and t2. t1 is the result of join query of tab1, and t2 is select statement from table variable t1. As last, the final statement, select all from the table variable t2, is executed. Then the procedure proc outer is finished. Now, let's check out how this inlined query is processed using SQL trace. To recall SQL trace, SQL trace is a trace to capture every single SQL statement that enters database. Like this case, when a procedure is run and all dependent queries are integrated in the main query, each statement is not executed individually through session layer, and this is not captured by default SQL trace setting. So to collect trace, we enable the internal statement configuration setting for SQL trace. Here is SQL trace that I captured to check query inlining. As all of you now know, in order to find the string, we can search schema name or query string. Then there is information for connection ID and transaction ID. And check out how the statement select all from tv2 is executed. As you can see SQL trace, firstly, it indicates the procedure proc outer with commenting. And as you can see, the blue and green highlights, those two statements are inlined with clause. And the statement using the table variable tv2 is executed. And let's check out how the statement select all from the table variable t2 is executed. As you can see in SQL trace, this statement is also inlined with using with clause. Like select all from the table variable tv2, when you look at the SQL trace, firstly, procedure proc outer is indicated at the very beginning with commenting. Then using with clause, The yellow and blue highlighted statements are inlined. Then the statement selected all from table T2 with green highlighted is executed. In case when the combined statements do not result in an optimal plan, we can prevent statements from being combined with other statements using no inline hint. So with the hint no inline, all the queries are executed one by one. But since the result of each query is executed individually, more memory consumption can be generated. So let's have a look at the previous example with no inline hint. This will block the statement to be inlined, and each statement will be executed individually. As you can see, if we specify the hint no inline, SQL trace shows each query is individually executed. Call proc inner is executed first with the variable tv2 and select all from the table variable tv2 is run. Then select all from table variable t2 is executed. At this part, we have learned about query inlining. Most of the time, query inlining is considered as beneficial, since it combines different SQL statements in order to optimize the database request. Therefore, many intermediate sequences are merged into one big step, and there can be performance gain. However, by doing so, the search space can be larger, and there can be a case suboptimal plan is generated. In this case, we can use no inline SQL hint to prevent inlining. Then all the statements can be executed individually. However, there can be memory consumption increase by doing so. Therefore, when you write the query, you should consider the characteristic of inlined and no inlined queries. That was about SQL tuning tips. And I've come to the end of this week. Thank you for your attention. In the upcoming week, we will look at case studies using the knowledge from the last unit. See you.